we took a kilometer of beautiful, transparent Antarctic ice and filled it with 5,000 of these sensors. And so when a neutrino comes in, makes a nuclear reaction, it makes this blue light, it makes a shock wave. We map the shock wave, we know we detected a neutrino, and we can even tell what direction it came from. And that makes it a telescope. If you go outside after the show and you look at the stars, the reason you see a picture of the sky is because the light comes in a straight line at you, so do these neutrinos. But just like you reconstruct a direction with your eye, we reconstruct it with this telescope. So it's very simple. You take a gigaton of ice and put 5,000 photomultipliers in it, which you buy in Japan.
Of course. But you have some drilling animation, too, to show.
Yeah, there are some minor details I left out. one of them that it took 20 years to do this. And this is how you put sensors in the ice. This is a tool that melts the snow layer at the top, which is about 100 meters thick. And then you have a jet of hot water under pressure that in about 2 days goes 2.5 kilometers deep. It just falls by its weight and melts the ice. And so at this point, you have a hole this big. But it's not really a hole, there is water instead of ice. And so then you sink your sensors into it. And of course, you first take the drill out because you have to use it again. And then once the sensors are in, you let the ice refreeze and you take data. You repeat this 86 times, you have your 5,000 in the ice. We completed this more than a year ago. And so we are happily taking data.